Praise the Lord, amen. Welcome to the service. Try Jesus. He's all right, amen. We want to welcome you all to the service, and it's a blessing to be in God's house, amen. And it certainly is a blessing just to say thank you and worship the Lord, amen, because without God, we could do nothing, and I just want to say that. We thank everybody who's been a part of the service, whether you sung or did something. We thank you, amen. And also today, we're going to have a good topic, amen, leading into our anniversary soon. It's going to be soon, July 26th. We'll make 4 years since I've been on the YouTube channel. And we're asking everybody to please donate $25 if you can, or 50 or more, amen. I'll be posting the information about the donation where you can send the donations to, but $25 or 50 or more if you can. We're asking all members of the ministry to do that, amen. Also, we want to just say good evening and welcome, amen. Hope you enjoy the service and the songs that you're about to hear and the worship, amen. We just want to say welcome, because this is a blessing to be in God's house, amen. And we're going to have some more songs, then we begin our service. I just want to say that it's a blessing to say thank you, Lord, because without God, I could do nothing. And I just want to say that, you know, a lot of people don't understand. God is like this here. He has kept me from a mighty long way. We're going to have this song playing called I've Been Just Gone Too Long. And we'll follow the rest of that. Amen.
Her glass art and jewelry business, she has it delivered free and fast from Staples.com.
I'm a business of one.
Do what you love with help from Staples.com.
Thank you.
Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I've been in a storm too long. Amen. Our scripture will be coming from, I'll be reading our devotion. Then we'll have our another song, another selection. Our scripture this afternoon is coming from the book of Philippians 2 and 5 as it reads, "Let the same mind in you that was in Christ Jesus." Philippians 2 and 5. Let us all go into prayer. Father God, I pray that you anoint the service. I pray, Lord, as we enter this service and as we are into this service, I pray that you're about to just shine your love down upon the people that's hearing and the viewers. I pray that you bless the viewers and bless the members of the both Facebook and YouTube ministry. I pray that you bless all of us, Lord. Bless us. Thank you for giving us 4 years, Father God, as we have come, Father, and we know we have made it, Father God. Lord, I pray that you bless the service, that it continue to be stronger and ever, and it be more to better. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen. Well, praise the Lord. Amen. God is worthy to be praised. I just want to say thank you again. Thank y'all for just being a blessing to this ministry. Amen. Whatever you do, it's a blessing to have you. Amen. Before we get into our next one, there's one particular person. I want to dedicate this video to my beautiful lady. I want to dedicate this video to her because without her, it's a blessing to have a good woman, but yet it's a blessing to have an encouraging woman and a wife, that is. And I dedicated this video to my woman to say that, to my beautiful darling and to my wife to say that I love you no matter what we do or go wrong. And I want to just tell you, God put this on my heart for you, but I'm not going to tell you what the message is going to be. The message is going to come soon. Just be prepared, amen. And I just want to say she's one of my biggest supporters and she's my secretary, but it's my wife as my secretary. And I love her so much dearly that she literally gives me strength. And I can honestly say that, no doubt about it, that she loves me and I love her because we have that mutual connection and understanding. And really, you know, it's a blessing to have a beautiful person that really cares about you. You know, and I say, you know, it's really beautiful. And I just want to say that I love her too much. And I can say that God really gave me a diamond when he gave me her. You know, and I just want to say we're going to play a little more gospel and then we're going to have a little more. But I just want to take time to tell you this video is dedicated to my beautiful wife and my nephew. My beautiful wife and my secretary as the same person. I love you and God bless you.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus, for blessing me. Amen. Hallelujah. Every day we should tell God, thank you. Because tomorrow could not be promised. Amen. I just want to say that. Before we do the dedication of who the video is dedicated to, I want to just say, everybody didn't talk about somebody, but I'm going to take the time out to really preach to y'all today. Y'all, we're going to have some good old-fashioned church. Amen. Before we're going to have 3 months before we begin, and before we do that, I want to just tell everybody, it's so good that when you love somebody from the heart, they love you back. Amen. And I just want to say this, a blessing. And really, without God, we could do nothing. And I just want to say that we're going to have two more selections. And before we give our song, before we give our word of God, we're going to have another song. We're going to have I Shall Wear a Crown. We're going to have I Shall Wear a Crown. Then we'll have I Told the Storm. Then we'll have our message. Thank you. Yes, hallelujah. As soon as I get home, I shall wear a crown. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Praise God. I shall wear a crown. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I want to wear a crown someday when I get over there. Amen. When I make it to the other side, I want to wear a crown. Hallelujah. Because God has been too good to us. Amen. I want to wear a crown. Hallelujah. After this, I will have our another selection. Then we'll have our message. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Give God some praise for good things he's done. Yes, hallelujah. I shall wear a crown. Amen, amen. Yes. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but if you know you shall wear a crown, you should thank God for how he brought you, for where he brought you from. Amen, yes, yes. Worship the Lord, worship him, thank him for his grace. Thank God for his grace and mercy, thank him. Hallelujah, yes, yes, yes. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah, I shall wear a crown, amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Yes, go on and worship him. Go on and worship him. Tell him thank you. Oh, yeah. Hallelujah, I shall wear a crown, amen, amen, hallelujah, yes, 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 amen. Oh, until the storm, amen. Praise the Lord, amen. Get your Bibles and turn with me to the book of Psalms, the 46th chapter, verse 1. What I told the storm, amen. Hallelujah. That's what I told the storm, amen. Praise God, he is worthy to be praised, amen. Today, I want to use as a subject for today is I told the storm, amen. Coming out of Psalms, the 46th chapter. Verse 1, as it reads, I would that you would pray. Coming out of the book of Psalms. Coming out of Psalms, the 46th chapter, verse 1, I would that you would pray, Lord, help me to tell the storm to pass over. I know my life is too short for the things I've been through, the things I've let drag me down. Father God, to come to you right now, Lord, I pray that you bless the word as it goes forth. I pray that you bless my voice that I shall speak of clarity. I pray that you bless my mind that I shall speak of understanding, that I'll be able to minister to your people and give them your word that you are happy behind the cross. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Bible, in the book of Psalms, written by David, of course, it reads as it said, God is my refuge and strength, very present help in trouble. So God is my refuge, but the question is, have you let him lead you all of these years of your life? Amen. Therefore, if God is our refuge, we should acknowledge God and say, well, God, I'm going to trust you to give me this and that. If you told the storm, you should know that what will last shall be first. Amen. Now, I like it how he said, God is my refuge. In a time of storm, you know, you got to take shelter. So therefore, we need God as our shelter because he provides us with the strongness against the storm. Amen. You notice how when a storm is on the way, they always tell you, be prepared. You notice how when you're in a relationship, you're going to have some not so good days and you're going to have some not so bad days, but they're still going to be good and bad. But you got to overlook them sometimes and see where God done brought you from. You're not the person that you once was before because you accepted change in your life. And when you accept change in your life, you begin to seek God first for who he is. You know, a lot of folks saying, well, I can do homosexuality. I can practice it. Now I can see that, well, folks marrying homosexuality couples, I won't do that. No. No homosexuality is not to be at my table, but I don't judge. But the Bible said in the book of Romans, the first chapter, 27 and 28, God gave them up to a reprobated mind. See, sometimes in life, we tell the storm, but we can have a reprobated mind to want to go back into the storm. So therefore, if you don't want to go back into the storm, what are you doing to get out that storm? What are you doing to get out the situation you in? But sometimes you feel like you want to give up because the weight of the world is on your shoulder. You feel like all hope is gone because you feel like there's no understanding in your heart. You feel like because God is not trying to listen to you. Number one, getting out the storm. Number one, write this down here. Number one, getting out the storm. When I get out the storm, I seek God as my refuge first. When I seek God as my refuge, I acknowledge him and realize the things I thought I could do, I could not do unless God is on my side. But I have to learn how to press my way through and make it to the other side. Therefore, when I make it to the other side, I see the hills and valleys and the mountains I've came over and came through. Amen. Let's move on to step two. Step two. The storm is almost passing over. So we talked about getting out the storm. What about it passing over? What about the refuge I spoke about a while ago, and I told you how Jesus says our refuge. Well, what about when I said God is our refuge and strength, but very present help in trouble? God is our refuge. We're not using it. But the passing of the storm means whatever you once was in, you need to get out of that situation. If you know that situation don't mean you no good, don't sit up there and stay there. If I know that situation ain't no good, I got to go. Well, the Bible said that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, and whichever shall believe it in him, they shall not perish, but have everlasting and eternal life on this earth. But if you know that, why have not you took heed to my words? As God is saying to us as Christians, we say we love God and we say that we put it all in God's hand, but here we are still holding grudges 10 days later or a year later. You mean you can't tell me you're a Christian, but you're still holding grudges against somebody that did you wrong 35, 45 years ago, 50 years ago? Well, let that go. Because the longer you hold grudges, the longer it causes you to fall in a lack of understanding. When I think about So, therefore, I told the storm, amen. I told God to say, give me strength. I say, Lord, help me to understand the things I cannot change. Well, when I told the storm, I say, Lord, let me fight my battle. Show me that I need to be better than I once was before. Amen. You know, a lot of people say, well, God know my heart, but your heart ain't where it should be. You can say I know God all you want. You can say I love God, but yet you too busy trying to straddle the line, as they call it, straddle the fence. And I know I'm finna step on some toes. You think that when you're in a relationship, you try to hide things from your wife or husband when you're married. Then when you're in a relationship, you try to hide things from your girlfriend or your boyfriend because you don't want them to find out what you've been doing. If you've been sneaking around doing something you have no business. See, that's where it calls God to tell you, no, step back. Let me take control of what's going on. See, you gotta understand, when God speaks, everybody shall listen. Well, when God speaks, everybody shall listen. I know a man who died. Yeah. But earlier, one Sunday morning, he got up out the grave with all power in his hand. They lay up in Joseph Bauer tune. He died. Yes, he did. He died for me and you. Grace and mercy. He saved a wretch like me. When folks don't think about it, they don't think about the grace of God. When you feel like the storm is too heavy, when you feel like you can't make it no more, God is able to carry you through. Go down on your knees, go down and you crack aloud and talk to God, talk to Dr. Jesus. Talk to Dr. Jesus. Yes. Oh, yes. Oh. Talk to Dr. Jesus. Won't he be a doctor in the room? Sometime when you're in a courtroom, you don't know if you're going to see life or death. Sometime when you're in a hospital, you don't know if tomorrow ain't promised. But God, God will. God will take care of you. Yes, he will. Well, sometime I look back over my life when I think about the times I did not want to preach. God set me down. He lifted me up. He placed my feet on a solid ground. I told the storm that I'm going to make it. My storm was hard. The storm taught me a lot. I came up poor, y'all. I did not have everything I wanted, but I appreciated everything that was done for me. And to my nephew, I want to say one thing. God bless me with you. As I love you every day, every time I get to see you, I see joy, nothing but joy. Every time you give me strength, you give me hope to go on and be the best person I could be, just to say I love you and that I care for you. Well, you got a good mama that's raising you to be the best mama you can be. Well, and to my wife, one day, God brought you into my life for a reason. When I did not look like I wasn't gonna make it, you showed me, you told me, you set me down and you talked with me. You told me how God is able. You told me to pray. You told me to do the right thing. But one thing you taught me, you taught me how to have faith. When faith was dead for me, you came in and helped me. When it did not look like I wasn't gonna make it. Well, God is good. Oh, God is good. Everybody don't understand. The Bible said in Proverbs 18:22, he who finds a wife finds a good thing. Well, they find it's a good thing to obtain favor from the Lord. You feel like today you want to know God? You can get to know him. Today is your day. Well, I come from a poor family. We didn't have much, y'all. I know some folks can identify you when you grow up in the country, Mississippi. They didn't have everything you wanted, but mama made do what it do. Mama worked hard. She worked hard day and night. Ain't God alright? Ain't he alright? Well, ain't he alright? Ain't he alright?
Remove all the bitterness. Heal
your Father God touch right now. In Jesus' name, pray. Amen. May God bless you and may God keep you.